Hey guys, welcome to a new episode of Wicked Comics, talking about the new comics coming out. Let's jump into it, because we have a decent amount to talk about here, starting with DC vs. Prime Pause. Books are beginning this week, there's only 3 DC books, it's actually been like weeks, so good for me. We have Suicide Squad, this is going to be no particular order, but we're going to do Suicide Squad 3-1, Construction Part 1. It's a new jumping on point for Suicide Squad. I've been enjoying the book, it's a fun book. Enchantress. She's gone. So she dies. So she's one of the main characters in Chinese Lee's dead. We'll see. She probably's gonna come back, but that's cool to read a new story after that. We have Entity Girl, however you wanna say it. It's a 3 of 6 non DC animal book. I'm excited. I love DC Animal. All the books, this is a mini series, so happy about that. And the next book is a book that's ending Batman White Knight issue 8. I'm excited for this the most out of everything because it's one of my favorite books. As of right now, it might be my favorite of the Elseworlds books. It's one of my favorite of the Elseworlds books. It's really good by Sam Murphy. It's just so great. So great. So now we're moving on to jumping on points. Okay, for new jumping on points for comics, we have Flash 46. It's the road to the Flash War. The Flash is, I guess, going to have a war. Cool, I guess, if you're reading Flash. I'm not really reading Flash comics. Not that I don't want to. A lot of books, I just can't get as many books as I can. Eventually, we'll probably read at some point, but Flash 46. New Flash book, awesome. This is a new jumping on point for that. We have Red Hood and the Outlaws 22. I put in here because it looked like they got like a single issue story arc. It looked like it was a jumping on point. We got the Penguin stuff in it. Very cool. If you're reading Red Hood and the Outlaws 22, great. We have Justice League No Justice number 1. This is about 14 pieces. I might be actually picking that one up. I'm not sure. I have to look at it. I think Scott Snyder's writing it. There's only 4 issues. I definitely might be in the realm of picking that up because if we can be small anyway, so that's not a bad idea. We also have Sideways, issue 4, another book that this has by Justin Jordan, who I just met at Free Comic Book Day, because he was at our comic book store. So that's really cool. I know he's doing this book, it looks really right. At some point, I do want to read it. Besides, issue 4 looks like it was the beginning of an arc. It might be the beginning of an arc, I'm not sure, so I just decided to put it under here. Last book for jumping on points, Wonder Woman 46, The Dark Gods, Part 1. Any jumping on point for that? The Dark Gods, I don't know, it's fighting some gods and stuff. This is the Wonder Woman book from I've read a couple weeks ago. It's really good. Check it out. This is a good place to jump on if you want to read Wonder Woman. So now we're going to ongoing stories. Okay, for ongoing stories. First thing I mentioned this, Scooby-Doo Apocalypse 25. Because I don't remember if I mentioned it in the last one. If I did, I missed it. If I did, great. If I did, okay, you're getting it twice. Scooby-Doo Apocalypse 25 looks like Fred's gonna die on that one. Holy shit, that actually looks kinda cool. Need to read that at some point. But the other ongoing stuff is Detective Comics 980 of Batman Elements Part 5, so not the best jumping on point, but if you like Detective Comics and be reading it, probably this is a good point to continue. We have Hal Jordan and the Green Lantern Corps 44, Doctor Rising Part 3, I like how the Doctor's also back in comics to see a kind of older team, an older comic book thing, so yeah, it's cool to see them back in the comics. So that's Part 3, so that's the best jumping on point, but still cool. Okay, Mortal Men issue 2, The End of Forever Part 2. This one's not too bad. You could go back, get you one, jump on that book. It's a new book, I think. I forget who's doing that one. I think Jim Lee, this one Jim Lee's doing. I'm not sure, but that looks really cool. A New Superman and the Justice League of China, 23. Sea of Change, Part 4. Another one, not a good jumping on point, but I've heard great things about the New Superman, King Kong, and the Justice League. So that looks really cool. I need to read that at some point. And the last book for this is Wildstorm, Michael Cray, issue 7, that comes out this week as well. That seems to be look like a mini series or continuing an arc, so yeah, I'm just gonna look like one consistent arc for that book, so I decided to put it here. And the last book, we have one more in ending. It looks like Batgirl and the Brother Play 22 will be ending this week, so if you've been reading that, final issue this week, I'm sorry about that. Final issue comes after that, so if you've been reading that, great issue, not too bad. And yeah, I feel like books as I'm looking at, you have Batgirl and you have this book, so yeah, you can end it, maybe then you're just about to pray book or something, but yeah, that's cool if you're reading that, check it out. Now we're on to Marvel. Now for Marvel, it's off with my ports, I can only one book this week, I thought Punisher used to come out this week. I guess not, sometimes stuff changes around, but we have Exiles number 3, what is, Exiles number 3. I'm really excited for this, this is actually one of my favorite books on Marvel right now, so I'm really excited for that book, so yeah, that's gonna be awesome. I'm gonna read it, it's been really cool, I wanna see what happens in the next issue, that's great. Now we're gonna go on to jumping on points, that's just the one book. We have Hunt for Wolverine, Animantium Agenda, issue 104, four TV series. Looks like gonna have like Luke Cage, Jessica Jones, Spider-Man, I think somebody else. Yeah, it looks like a cool book. that looks cool. If you've been wanting more for the Hunt for Wolverine, there you go, another book for that. And we have a couple number ones this week. We have Star Wars Last Jedi, the adaptation number 1 of 6. It's a 6-issue miniseries of basically just a movie adaptation of the Star Wars Last Jedi comic. If we're doing it now and not like when the movie comes out, but whatever. It's still cool if you want to check that out, you can check that out. We have a beautiful scoreboard, 32. It looks like the beginning of a new arc for this book with her and Kraven the Hunter. So if you've been enjoying that and want to check it out, that's a good book. That's one of the best books I would say in the moment. That's a good all-age book. So a book I feel like a kid can read pretty much fine. And then we have Venom number 1 coming out this week. The new Venom issue 1 for the new Venom series. I'm excited. Not as super excited as cool as Venom because the new book's number 1. So that's cool if you like Venom. I like Venom, but I'm probably going to check this out. But yeah, cool. Venom number 1 coming out. I know a bunch of other stuff is getting new number 1s. So that's cool. So we're going to jump into ongoing stories. So for ongoing stories, because we have a lot, we'll just go through the 5th. We have Despicable Deadpool 300. This is the 300th issue of Despicable Deadpool for this comic, since they redid the numbering like not that long ago. But yeah, I don't know if this is the last issue, because I know there's going to be a new Deadpool number 1, so I don't know if this 300th issue is the last one, and the next issue is going to be the 5th issue by Scott Young. But I don't know, but that's still cool. If you want to read it, you can read Deadpool. It looks like a really cool book. I don't know, since this is a big festival, so I don't know if this is going to be a good jumping on point or not. Just had to throw it in here. We have the second issue to Domino, comes out this week. If you don't know who Domino is, he's been on with Cable a lot in the new Deadpool movie. So yeah, issue 2 of that's coming out, if you've been reading that. If you read the 5th issue, you can go back and check it out, because it's not too bad. So if you want to read it, go back and check issue 1. Or check issue 2, it might be a jumping on point, then I couldn't really tell. But we have Incredible Hulk 716, but a part of World War Hulk 2, continuing that story arc. It didn't say what part, but it's continuing that event or story, so yeah. Probably it's not been as good as the original, but I don't think anything's going to be. But Incredible Hulk 716, if you want to check it out, we got that coming out this week. This wasn't too bad for Marvel this week. It's actually pretty light for Marvel. It was not a bad week this week. I think this is a fairly good week for comics, not too much, so. Out of the stuff I put, mind you. We have New Mutants and Dead Soul, issue 3 of 6. It's a 6-issue miniseries featuring New Mutants and a new book obviously leading up part of the Sony movie. That's cool, it's just a miniseries, so whatever, if you've been enjoying it. Yeah, continue reading that if you've been reading it. We have Old Man Logan 39. Couldn't tell if it was a jumping off point or not, so I just had to throw it in here. Old Man Logan 39 is, I've seen stuff where it looks cool. I want to finish the Jeff Lemire one, and then I'm kind of debating if I eventually want to. This is a book I would eventually might, I would get in my box, but I would have to get caught up and stuff. But yeah, that's a cool. Old Man Logan is great. It's a great book, so check it out. Peter Parker, The Spectacular Spider-Man 304. I think this is the one, if I might, Chip Zdarsky doing. I read some okay things about this book, and I'm actually, another Spider-Man book, this is the one I'm most inclined to check out, not counting Spider-Man plus Deadpool, but also on this list, we'll get to that in a minute. But yeah, Spectacular Spider-Man, Peter Parker, Spectacular Spider-Man 304, great, couldn't tell what the beginning of an arc or not, it looked like its own thing, so yeah, if it's that, cool, check it out. We have Runaways, number 9, Best Friends Forever, continuing the Best Friends Forever story, like the Best Friends Forever continues, this is continuing that story arc, I guess. So yeah, Runaways issue 9, I don't hate the Runaways, I actually think the Runaways comics are fine. So if you like Runaways, go check that out. We have what I said earlier, Spider-Man Deadpool comes out this week, issue 32. Oldies, part 3, so the third part for this story arc. Not the best jumping on point, but if you like Spider-Man Deadpool, check it out. It's a cool book, I think it's a cool book. Deadpool out really well. Then for Star Wars, we have those coming up next. We have Star Wars, Dark Vader 16. It's Star Wars Dark Vader books, I couldn't tell. So I was like, okay, these Star Wars books need to be, some of them need to be a little more. I wish they sold more for the Star Wars book to say like, oh, this is part 2 or story or something, or saying what book or something to give me a little more indication, but I thought for Star Wars Dark Vader 16. There's all the Dark Vader books from what I've read, I feel like you can jump on almost any of them. But it's also, feels like it might be one because of the story, I don't know. But decided to put it here, Star Wars Dark Vader issue 16 comes out. I've read some of the series, it's really good, check it out. We have Star Wars Swan. Star Wars Swan? Swan? THRAWN? Swan? It is issue 4 of 6, it's a mini series. It's coming close to an end, so yeah. If you wanna, you can read that, check that out. If you don't, I'd maybe say wait for the trade. Once you get near the end, I say usually wait for the trade, or if you wanna go back and pick up something like you used to do that. But yeah. So that's all we have for Star Wars, those two books. We have two more books for Marvel. We have X-Men Blue, 27. I couldn't tell if this was beginning arc. It looked like it was kind of continuing of something, or wasn't like a good jumping on point. But yeah, X-Men Blue 27 comes out if you've been reading that. Check it out. And last but not least, Euro Deadpool issue 205 is a weekly series that's been coming out. It looks cool. Not bad for a weekly series. I think it looks cool. So yeah, 205 of Euro Deadpool. So that's going to be ending really soon. That's it for the Marvel stuff. So let's jump into Indie. Because we have a decent amount, not too much, but we have some. Yeah, to start off, we have Boom Studios, and we have two for Boom. I thought it was worth mentioning. We have Adventure Time Comics, issue 23. Obviously, Adventure Time, I like Adventure Time, so I don't think they'll come out the Adventure Time regular show, most of these costumes, but because they're great shows. So that came out this week. That was pretty epic and awesome. We also have RoboCop, Citizens Arrest, issue 2, the second issue for this story arc. Really found that enjoyable. I think it's... I don't know why I find it enjoyable. It's a cool book that they're bringing RoboCop back into a new series. So I'm really happy with that. So that's pretty cool. So if you want to check RoboCop out, I haven't been reading. I don't know why I said that, but RoboCop issue 2 is great. I mean, it's great if you want to read a RoboCop book. I think RoboCop is cool. It doesn't mean like a new book. We have Archie. We have nothing but Archie for Black. Dark Horse, I think we have one. BPRDW96. This is one of the books part of the Hellboy universe. It's had Hellboy on the cover and stuff. I said to mention it. Not much now. It looks like a cool spot. I think it's the group. Like, it's kind of like the S.H.I.E.L.D. group or whatever in the Hellboy universe. I think that's what the book is. Not sure, but issue 6 is that coming out. So if you want to check it out, check that out. And then for, I wouldn't jump to other stuff. And then we'll do the other ones last. But for other stuff, there's a couple books that weren't by any of the other books. There's a book by Titan Comics. We have Sea of Thieves issue 3. It's over 14 minutes. It's based on a new game. Then the game looks fine, so I started to pump out the comic by Titan Comics. They do like a lot of the Assassin's Creed and stuff, so that's it's cool. Sea of Thieves issue 3 or 4. Not a good jumping on point, but hey, it's cool. And also I have Robotech issue 9. How could I not mention Robotech? Old school, as an anime fan and an old school anime fan, I have to mention Robotech issue 9. So that's coming out this week as well. Let's jump on to the last of the indie stuff with IDW, Image, and Valiant. Last for the indie stuff, starting with, I guess for the Valiant, there wasn't anything, so Valiant, there wasn't anything for us, so Valiant's off the table, so there's nothing new for that. For Image, there's only two, we have Young Blood issue 11, A Tale of Two Young Bloods, it looks like the name of the story. So cool, I actually been running the new Young Blood series, I read the first four issues of it, I had the first four issues of them. They're really good, I definitely want to read more of it, so yeah, read the book, I definitely will get this at some point. Then we have Medieval Spawn and Witchblade, number 104. A 4-issue miniseries with Medieval Spawn, so it's cool. And then it's a crossover book with Witchblade, so it's cool. That's a cool indie book, Image book, so that's cool. That one I might have to look at this week, because that looks kind of interesting. And last but not least, we're going to do IDW, we have a bunch. So we have Star Wars. We have Star Wars Adventures number 10. Maybe the more kid-friendly Star Wars books. You can say what you want why Marvel's not doing it, but I actually like this one, and also Derek Chum is doing the art for some of it, so that's cool. I like his art. His art for Star Wars looks really cool. In issue 10, this is Powered Down, part 1 of 2. It's a 2-part story arc. This looks like it's about Chewbacca and Han, so that looks like really cool. It actually looks really good. Then we have Back to the Future Time Train issue 5, the 5th issue to this new Doc Back to the Future series. So that's like really cool. You've been enjoying this. It looks like it's about the Doctor, Doc Brown. Really cool. Another great issue for that. Just great. And then we have Ghostbusters. It's the call number 5. What Dreams May Come, part 5. So we have a new Ghostbusters. We used to have a new Ghostbusters series. So that's cool. Ghostbusters, another book. Really cool. Ghostbusters and Back to the Future are always great. And last but not least, the book is the final issue. We have the final issue to Ron. And then Micronauts crossover issue 5 of 5. So that's ending this week. And that's it for new comics that came out this week. Thank you guys for watching this new episode of What's New in Comics. We talk about all new comics that come out. Thank you guys for watching this. You guys tell me in the comments what books are you excited for this week. What books are you going to be picking up at your comic book store. What books are you excited for. What books are you getting. What books are you interested in. Let me know in the comments below. And as always, you can stay epic. And I'll see you in the next video, guys. Bye.